Today I'm giving you three underrated table service restaurants at Walt Disney World in Orlando, Florida. Shh. Don't tell anyone, we don't want them to know. But I'll give you the inside info right after that intro. Roll that intro.
Yeah, I just wanna see the light.
Hi all, Keith here. Welcome to the video. Before we go too much further, make sure you pause the video, click the subscribe button, and ring that notification bell so you don't miss any upcoming videos. Let's talk dining at Walt Disney World. Everyone always goes to the most popular, hard to get in places, and that's all you hear about, it seems like, in the Disney community. But instead of wasting your time trying to get that hard reservation for one of the overhyped, underwhelming restaurants, try these instead. First on my list is my personal favorite character experience at Walt Disney World, and that's the Garden Grill at Epcot. To me, this is a way better dining experience than Chef Mickey's at the Contemporary. Why? For one, if you're going to a restaurant, you want to eat, right? Right. And the food is just so much better at the Garden Grill than at Chef Mickey's. Plus, the cool, unique setting in the Land Pavilion in the rotating restaurant overlooking Living with the Land is way better to me than the cold, modern interior of the Contemporary. Also, I don't know what it is, but the character interactions at the Garden Grill seem way better too. I think it's because the restaurant isn't as large as the Chef Mickey's restaurant there, so the characters can spend more time at your table interacting with your family. So for the food, the atmosphere, and the character interactions, the Garden Grill is an underrated gem at Epcot, for sure. Second is 50s Primetime Cafe. Now I know a lot of people overlook this restaurant because Sci-Fi Dine-In is probably the most popular restaurant there at Disney's Hollywood Studios, but you really shouldn't overlook it. No shade to Sci-Fi Dine-In, but for me, 50s Primetime is a better experience all the way around. First, when you walk into this restaurant, the theme is amazing. It's like you step back into Grandma's kitchen. Also, for me, the real star of this restaurant are the amazing cast members. They're always cutting up and giving you a hard time. If you want a real good time, try putting your elbow on the table or holding your cell phone while you're trying to eat. It's hilarious. The food here is amazing too, with Aunt Liz's fried chicken probably being the star of the show here. But don't sleep on Cousin Megan's traditional meatloaf or Mom's old-fashioned pot roast. It's all amazing. They also have a wide range of unique mocktails and cocktails from Dad's Liquor Cabinet. For the amazing food and the outstanding cast members, 50s Primetime Cafe shouldn't be missed on your next trip to Disney's Hollywood Studios. Our last restaurant on this list takes us to Disney's Animal Kingdom to check out the Yak and Yeti restaurant. I know Tiffin's or Tusker House tends to get the praise here at Disney's Animal Kingdom for good reason, but if you want a unique experience with great food, then head to Asia to the Yak and Yeti. First, let me say, the food selection here is huge. There's anything from safe options for kids like hamburgers or chicken tenders, to a wide range of selections for adults, such as the amazing Korean beef, to my favorite, the chicken tikka masala. I also always feel like the atmosphere in this restaurant is like calming and sort of like a respite from the craziness of the theme park outside the doors. Plus, the portions are generous and the prices are reasonable. So for the calming atmosphere, the delicious food, and the great prices, you should definitely check out the Yak and Yeti restaurant on your next trip to Disney's Animal Kingdom. There you have it, three underrated table service restaurants at Walt Disney World. What's your pick for underrated restaurant at Walt Disney World? Let me know in the comments down there below. Also, hang out for just a little bit longer because we'll have some end cards with some video suggestions, and we'd love it if you'd watch another video. Don't forget to like the video and share it with a Disney fan you think would get some use out of this video. Make sure you're subscribed down there below and click the notification bell so you don't miss any upcoming videos. Click the join button down there to find out all the great benefits of becoming a member of the channel. We also have a merch shelf down below this video that you should definitely check out right after this video is over. Also, check out our coffee page. It's just a way for you to drop us like a virtual tip or buy us a coffee. Any way you choose to support the channel, we really appreciate it. I'd like to pause and thank everyone who made it this far into the video. Y'all are really in it with us, and we appreciate you more than you know. Make sure you pause the video and write underrated Disney down there in the comments to let me know you made it this far into the video. All right, everyone, we'll catch you in the next video. Thanks a lot for watching. Peace and love.